Let's have some fun while learning with animation. This is how to learn Scratch programming language. The Scratch program language is free, fun, and easy to learn. Most program languages are text-based, so a learner has to gain experience writing the code. But Scratch program is easier as it uses blocks. The learner selects blocks, puts them together, and runs the program in a simple way, making it the most fun and easiest way to learn programming. To complete this task, we need to look at the instructions. So follow the instructions. You can download them from this website and look under task 5, animation, and then download the instructions. We start off with a new sprite, so we can remove the cat and look for an octopus, which we'll find under animals. So now we have our octopus. We can change the size to, say, 40. So that's quite small. Now we need a glide. We need to glide 1 second to X and Y. Now X and Y, we want some random numbers. So under operators, we can see pick random. So we can say 240 to 240. And we need two values, one for X, one for Y. So that could be our X and our Y, slightly smaller, 180 to 180. So we can put that inside our glide, and we can put our glide inside a forever loop. So we can see that. That's the whole block. We're going to add another sprite. So let's look in our library, and we're going to look for a dragon. Now that's quite big, so we're going to move that down to 40. So what we're going to do with our dragon? Well, we're going to first of all use a loop, and then we're going to say we're going to move it. So it's going to move one step, and also if it's on edge, it's going to bounce. We want the dragon to be chasing the octopus, so we're going to use the point towards block and put in octopus. So now the dragon will move towards the octopus. We can test it to see if it works now. So we're going to click the green flag and see if the dragon moves around. You can see it does move towards the octopus. Not very fast, but it does move. And red dot to stop. We want to change the octopus, so we're going to change from the glide to point towards mouse pointer. So again, we need to start when the green flag is clicked, and we need to move, let's say, 10 steps. We want it to stop once it reaches the mouse. So we can do that using the sensing block by touching mouse pointer. But we want it to move when it's not touching. So we can use the not operator. So we can put that in our green operator block. And in our controls, we have an if. So what we want to move if we're not touching the mouse pointer. So that's our code to move the octopus when it's not touching the mouse pointer. So you saw in our demonstration about how the dragon went around, which wasn't that great. So what we're going to do is we're going to set the rotation style. So we don't want any rotation style for the octopus. And for the dragon, we can just have the rotation style from left to right. We want something to happen when the dragon touches the octopus. So we can do that in sensing. So when the octopus is touching the dragon, we want something to happen. So we can use the if statement again. And then perhaps we can have, say, You've got me. You also need the when green flag is clicked. So now when the octopus is being touched by the dragon, we can say it says you got me. Now if you're following along with this and you test it, you might find it doesn't work. And there's a reason for that. It's because we've forgotten a block. We've forgotten the forever block. And if we don't use, let's do that correctly, if we don't use the forever block, then the touching dragon will not work. So even just one single block, if you forget it, then the code is different and therefore it doesn't work how you want. So to be careful when you're following instructions and also be careful when you're coding. Let's return to the main video and we'll add the forever block at the end on the final code. We want to look at the dragon's costumes now. So if we click on the dragon and look at costumes, we can see there's three. So the first one is good. The second one is flying, so we don't need the dragon flying. The third one is to breathe fire, so we'll keep that. So let's go back to the code. We're going to add the switch costumes. So we want to switch costume, and we're going to add two. First, we're going to switch to C, and then we're going to switch to A. So we need, again, we go back to our if. We need our if else block. And then we're going to change costume when it's touching the octopus. So we go back to sensing, if touching, octopus. Again, when the green flag is clicked, now we want to change the costumes of the octopus, so we look what we've got. We've got quite a few, so we don't really need the plain drums or have the hat or the third one. So we only really need one and two. Now we're going to change the costume, so we can look at changing the costume to make him look like he's burnt. So we're going to use a fill color of black. And we can use the paint tool to colour in some black legs so he looks coloured black. We also might want to draw some smoke coming from when he's been burnt, something like that. Now our code, we're going to look at the code from the dragon, and we can drag that into the octopus. So now we've got when touching, if we look at the octopus, we've got when touching dragon, we're going to switch to octopus, when touching dragon, octopus B and octopus A when not. We've already got the touching dragon code, so perhaps we can put this together here. Move out so you've got me down, and then we don't need those blocks. We want them to start in different positions, so we can use the go to block to start off with. So the octopus we want to start at 180, 150. And the dragon we can use the block and start the dragon at minus 240 and minus 180. So they start in different positions. We can add some of the scratch features here. So for example, the background, we can look for some background of underwater, if we can find that. Is underwater. So we're going to have underwater background, and now we're going to look for some sound. So we can click the background, and then on the sounds we can see pop here. So we can play sound pop. Play sound pop, and then put that inside a forever loop and then use that when the green flag is clicked. Rather than that just playing exactly the same in the background, we could use a wait and then use a random number. So we go back to our operators, pick random, something like from 0 to 4 seconds, or maybe even just 1 to 4 seconds. So then there's a delay between these sounds. So let's have a look at that. When we run that, we can move the octopus, we can hear the pop sounds. And then if the dragon touches the octopus, you've got me for 1 second. So we can move the octopus around with the mouse. Here we go. So final look at the code. Octopus, dragon, background 0 or 1. That's our game. Well, we hope you enjoyed that. Now, if you're interested in learning more or learning other programming languages, then please subscribe. And every time a video comes out, if you hit that notification bell, then that will let you know. So enjoy your learning.